play some of those tunes real quick. Because you probably never heard them before.
Thank you.
Security, security. That's like the old Jimi Hendrix tapes when the his guitar is so loud it's picking up the security's walkie-talkies. Security, security. From the movie Crossroads, y'all remember that when the Karate Kid got the blues? And face Steve Vai on the guitar, yeah. I was like 14. I thought that was tough. It did turn me around too, because like, you know, blues had been in my family and, you know, I heard it all my life, but I never really went there for myself until I saw that movie, and then I was like, wow, you know, hey. And I actually remember being in the car, you know, in the back seat and talking to my dad, and I was actually embarrassed to say, you know, man, that blues is kind of cool, man. Maybe I could, you know. So he hooked me up with some tapes, some Jimmy Reed, and man, he used to show me all kinds of cool stuff. He'd show me just like, he would say, you could play that guitar, and then I'll pick it up, and I'll be louder than you. Same guitar. And he'd say, Joseph Spencer, pick it up, be louder than me. And he was just telling me how you gotta play it. He showed me little songs that helped. First thing I ever learned was Bo Diddley. Because if y'all should look into this, I mean, your little ones, get ready. Like this, same tuning. I hadn't progressed at all since then. The guitar is tuned to a chord, so it was harmonious right there. So for, like, you know, because at first I got the guitar and I was trying to learn the chords or whatever, you know, and I was completely untalented. I had nothing going on, but I wanted to do it. I was just a little kid. Cody, on the other hand, was like playing Chuck Berry. But anyway, my mom probably said, just tune it to open tuning. So he showed me Bo Diddley. So he tuned it to the chord and showed me Bo Diddley, and it was perfect for a little kid. Just... I remember being a little kid, standing outside the window. I had a little plastic amp. Just rocking, man. In my mind, I was rocking. I'm talking about little kid. Peter's mom, she played piano in the Baptist Church in Memphis, so we'd go up. Saturday we had guitar lessons, and we'd spend the night with our grandparents and go to church with them. Sunday morning I listened to my grandmother play piano, and that's where I got my love for gospel music. I still just love it so much. Part in there, she never played that. I lay down my burden down by the riverside, down by the riverside, down by the riverside. I lay down my burden down by the riverside. Ain't gonna study, oh no more. Ain't gonna study, oh no more. Ain't gonna study, oh no more. Ain't gonna study war no more. I ain't gonna study war no more. I ain't gonna study war no more. I ain't gonna study war no more.
Thank you.
unorthodox in store. My friend used to tell me, one of my good friends, I have a couple of friends from home who aren't musicians, but, you know, mess around, or we used to mess around, but they love music, they're real music lovers, I always trust their opinion. And he used to always say, he still says that, man, if you just make a record of like what you sit around and do in the bedroom, that's what people want. I don't know what all this other stuff is you do in there. And I thought, oh man, it's so hard to do that. It's like the hardest thing to do. The studio can be evil. You get in there and start messing around. So I just try and keep it as real as possible. So anyway, I'm missing my grandmother. I wrote this song the day she passed. Headed out walking, nobody by my side. You see me, allow me to pass on by. Pass on by, pass on by. Headed out walking, headed up over yonder, headed up over yonder. Biding my time to the sweet by and by, we all meet again at the home on high. Home on high, sweet by and by, we all meet again at the home. Headed up over yonder, headed up knows, you know, I go to the airport or whatever, she's going up, up, and then she does this, like, hey, you know, she knows, she's up, she knows what's going on. But the yesterday morning when the guys came to get me, we were packing up the van and stuff, she's like, and she took me and led me back inside, she's like, you stay in the house. But I just got home. different, you know. And you know, and this next song I wrote after my father passed, right before she was born. I don't go around playing some of these songs in public, but since y'all came to this, you know, it's not like a rock and roll show.
Me by, see you later, son. Here for your father, come for you later. Here for your father. When the day comes, death comes back my way. I would hope to be as brave as he was on Judgment Day. I would hope to be as brave. He was on Judgment Day. Ain't no grave hold his body down. No grave hold his body down. Ain't no grave hold his body down. Bless our dear mother, he was her heart. Comes a time soulmates must part. Been side by side from the start. She gave him strength to carry through. Face the one thing we all have to do. Face the one thing we all have to do. I would hope to be as brave as she was on Judgment Day. Hold his body down, no grave. Hold his body down. Hold his body down. It's been my fortune to know truly great men. I've heard the music of the spheres. Heard the music of the spheres. I am unrepentant, I have no fear for the music of the since I recorded it. And usually that's not a big deal. That's about how we usually roll. But it's kind of got a lot of parts in it. But I just want to try it out. I wrote it in Breckenridge, Colorado. I messed around with it. And then recorded it one day backstage. Let's try this. Breckenridge Blues. Na na na, it's way too fast.
I was on tour, it reminded me I was on tour, the first Sopniff string band tour, and Alvin Youngblood Hardy likes pawn shopping, so we always hit the pawn shops, and I found it. I got things, and appreciate it, and he took me to the pawn shop, and I found a fiddle. I was like, oh yeah, I'm gonna play the fiddle. So I practiced it all the way, much to their chagrin, I practiced it the whole way down to Houston that day. And played it, you know, I was like, had it in my lap, I was just playing. And so after, you know, I was like, yeah, I've practiced all day, you know, played on this song. And after the song, somebody was like, keep practicing. That was the end of my fiddle career. It was a show. Their heart, they moved to Memphis and took me under their wing because I love them. It's an old, you know, it's old, it's an old looking guitar, but the P90s, old style. All right, so we got all the blood rolling. That Birmingham Blues was funny, man, because they woke me up we were in some vehicle and they woke me up. They're like, all right, man, you gotta go play on TV and nobody else is gonna, kind of like this, nobody else is gonna come. And I don't mind. I prefer it. Because it's different to me. I like this, you know, it's different in rock and roll. And if, and I can't speak for the other guys, so when I'm by myself, I can speak freely. And I speak a lot of trash. But anyway. So they wake me up and they take me there, and then there's a big breaking news that day, Birmingham. And we don't know if we have time for you, you know, but maybe we'll put you on at the very end. And I didn't have, that's nothing I wanted to play at 9 in the morning that day. And so I was sitting there in this freezing room watching TV, waiting to maybe play. And I just kept talking about the sad situation. So I just wrote the song, and I just wrote down what they were saying and put it together into a tune, a blues song, and went out there and played it, and man, that woman was horrified. You can see it. I mean, she's like, oh, well now, you know, he's just a musician now. We don't take this seriously. And I was like, yeah, I know you don't. Neither do I. Woke up the morning, heard the news. Birmingham got the mail, Langford Blues, Birmingham got the news, got the old Birmingham, Alabama, Mill Langford Extortion Blues. I've been working on the lyrics a little bit. The 5th of April, mighty sad day, the mail Langford again is day 5th of April. Might a sad day. May your Langford begin his day. I rode to the jailhouse at Great Long Limousine. May your Langford turn it money green, rode to the jailhouse in great long limousine. You know that old Mayor Langford turning money green. The poor folk in Birmingham screaming and crying. Screaming and crying. I got a new verse, so I don't know if I'm gonna use it though. So, y'all let me know what you think about a new verse. Mel Langford, Lord, out on the town, eating them chicken dinners, throwing that money around. Lord, Mel Langford, I don't think it's appropriate. Lord, out on the town. I like drinking that champagne, Lord, throwing that money around. So what did he do anyway? Oh, Lord. Did he now? Yeah, but I mean, you know where he messed up? He got caught. Poor guy. I wonder if he ever saw it.
He spent too much money.
Yeah, he went too far. I like this one. For some reason, I always sing about the pigeon wing. The pigeon wing, because it rhymes with thing. Shake with your I'm glad I only ran off one infant. That was great. I know we're keeping it quiet. Thank you.